Rosie. Would you please close the door, window?
Close the door.
The window, sorry. لا خليه شغال.
خليه
شغال.
What about behind you? Well, the window's open. You're okay with that?
No. I didn't notice. Okay. Okay. Syria. Syria. Syria in Arabic. Syria. Syria means sun. Because the sun always shining. And this name about 3,000 years old is Aramaic name. As a national symbol of Syria, it was this disk of sun.
Stop, please.
Yeah, I stop.
I gotta get my camera out. I didn't know it was gonna be so good.
You tried me before, and you told me.
عفوك
عم لو لقاءات معي ونبسط كل أنحاء العالم. وقت الضربة تبع عمي.
Tommy'd be that good. Okay, hold on. Okay, sir. Sorry about that.
Don't worry. Syria. Syria in Arabic means Syria. Syria means sun. This is an Aramaic name. And the national symbol of Syria, it was this disk of sun. If you go to northeast of Syria, you can see many sites, and you can see the sign. National symbol of Syria. National symbol of Syria now, an eagle. But in that time, this disk of sun. Before I tell you about the history, let me tell you something about a human being here in Syria. By the way, some information about history may be against the things, religious things. So I'm talking about history, not about religions. About a human being. A human being here in Syria, more than 1 million. We discover all over Syria some human remains, some skeleton, skull, bone, and some basic tools, stone tools used by humans, about 1 million years. In north of Aleppo, in Valley of Afrin, where the action now, we discover a skeleton of a child. This one, in a tomb. And that tomb, 100,000 year old. This is important, you know why? 100,000 years ago, humans, they start to think in Syria about death, about afterlife. So they didn't throw the body. They put this body of a child in a hole in the land. They put stone under his head, and they cover the body by stone. This first organized tomb in the world. Human in that time, they started to think about this afterlife, so this is very important. Also in Palmyra, we discover a human skull. That a human skull also about 500,000 years old. I'm not going to say Syria cradle of civilization. Civilization was born here in Syria. Why? I'm going to give you some sign. Why? Abdul, he said, civilization was created here in Syria. Let me start by irrigation system. Irrigation system in two sites in Syria, in Ghouta and north of Aleppo, we discover some remains of irrigation system 11,000 year old. Afrin and Ghouta. It's amazing. Also about the writing, not the alphabet, later I tell you something about. About the writing, first sign of writing discovered here in Syria, we discover some stone tablet with some carvings. At that time, Syrian, they use the shape of animal or bird or trees as the signs of writing. 8,000 BC, 10,000 year old. And later, around 4th millennium BC, we use another way of writing. It's called cuneiform. Cuneiform on the clay tablet, 4000 BC. And this way of writing lasted till first millennium BC. We use it as artwork. But what about this writing? We use more than 2,000 samples. 2,000 samples is not easy for anyone to learn. But what Phoenicians did for to find solution of this, they choose instead of 2,000 samples, only 30 letters, 30 samples. And from that time, human, it was easy for the human to learn language. And all the alphabet, all over the world, taken from Phoenician alphabet. This I repeated this one, 1993, to show.
You know how they know that?
Yeah.
The order is the same. It's always ABC.
Yeah, look here. This Phoenician.
Yeah.
Aramaic.
Arabic.
Greek. Latin. All the tourists, when I show this page, they told me, second one, Abdul, is Hebrew. Hebrew is Aramaic.
Right, of course, the language. 100%.
Language which was spoken by Jews and by Jesus Christ.
And so in Malula.
Same Malula. So, this very proud, we are first alphabet in the world. This 1400 BC. This alphabet, Phoenician. 1400 BC. This about writing. About cities here. All the cities in Syria, not Damascus, not Aleppo. All the city in Bukros. Bukros in near Deir ez-Zor, in east of Syria. That city, 7000 BC. And we discover in that city houses, different rooms and kitchen. And a wheat storage, 7000 BC, 9000 year old. If we talk about mother cities, like cities surrounded by walls,
yeah.
We have five cities. Important five cities and very ancient. Aleppo, Ibla near Aleppo, south of Hama, Mishrefe near Homs, and Damascus. These five cities, third millennium BC, 5,000 year old. It was surrounded by wall with four gate or different gates. Especially city of Ibla. Ibla is the most important one. Why? Let me tell you something about Ibla. Ibla, it was surrounded by wall. That wall, 20 meter thick. Can you imagine? 5,000 years ago, Ibla, it was surrounded by wall, and that wall, it was 20 meter thick and 30 meter high. Unbelievable. With four gates. And what important, very, very important about Ibla, library. We discover famous archives in Ibla, consist of 17,000 cuneiform tablets. Our information about Syrian history, about the world history, radically changed after discovery of Ibla. Because that archive cover everything, politics, education, medicine, everything. And Ibla, unbelievable city. Why? First school in the world constructed in Ibla 5,000 years ago. Something unbelievable also, tell Mr. Trump and others. This is something very important about democratic life. In Ibla, we have parliament. And that parliament in Ibla 5,000 years ago. In Ibla, we have oldest olive press. In Ibla, first medical conference held in Ibla. Just to remind you again, Ibla 5,000 years ago, old. Something I can talk weeks about Ibla. Till sometime, the tourists, they told me, Abdul, Ibla, your love, because you talk a lot about Ibla. Yes, Ibla, my love. Inshallah, one day, I'm take you to show you Ibla. And this here, you can see one tablet of Ibla is a message from King of Ibla to another king, written in very diplomatic way and very friendly. I will make copies of this document to you if you're interested. So, I was talking about cities also. All the school, I told you on Ibla, all this parliament, all this medical conference, cities surrounded by walls, this gate. Not only Ibla, Damascus, Hama, and Mishrefe, east of Homs. Something also very important. The oldest musical note written in Ugarit near Latakia, 1400 BC. Musical note. And that tablet in Damascus Museum now. What we don't know, and many Syrians they don't know, we have in Syria the oldest stadium in the world, 1600 BC. And that stadium can sit about 11,000 spectators, 3,600 year old. And the sport game which held there in that stadium recorded in archives of Ugarit. Ugarit, the site of first alphabet, Phoenician, 2000 BC. I think you don't know that. Janice and others last time in, I think in October, they went there and they visited that stadium. Okay. Unbelievable. And there's a documentary for the BBC, maybe you can check. Unbelievable. You know what's the meaning of 11,000 spectators in that time? The population of Amrit, this is a city, is called Amrit, where we discover a stadium. The population of that city in that time, 4,000. And they have a stadium, 11,000. Even now, 11,000 is a big number. So, the first organized sport game held in Syria, not in the Greek, in the Greece. Once I was guiding a Greek group, when I start to talk about that, they told me, Abdul, stop talking. Wallah, we kill you. And then after that, I give them lectures. Also, so there were some professors. He was sitting beside me. He agreed 100% what I'm talking about. And we took them to visit. And that professor, he said something very important for the media that time also. He said the root of all great Greek civilization from Syria. And he mentioned sport game, music, language, everything, the root of that culture, Greek culture, Phoenician, that's from Syria. This some sign or some make focus why I said civilization was created here in Syria. Then 1000 BC till today, Syria is a mosaic of cultures. You heard about Silk Road. Silk Road. Many important stations of the Silk Road in Syria, like Palmyra, Aleppo, Damascus, and Tartus. So because that road, Syria became mosaic or crossroad of civilizations. Also, many nations occupied Syria, like Alexander the Great captured Syria in the year 333 BC. In that time, Syro-Greek civilization started, and then Roman captured Syria 64 BC, during till late of 4th century. So about 350 years of Roman time in Syria. During that time, Syrians, they were very active. You know why? Two things. Some Syrian emperors ruled Rome, like Philip the Arab, Julia de Mona and her family. Julia de Mona, she is from Homs. Julia de Mona and her family ruled Rome about 40 years. You know Caracalla, maybe. Caracalla, he was a Syrian emperor. Not only that, this is something more important about Syrian emperor ruled Rome. There's a Syrian architect. His name, Apollodor. His name, Apollodor the Damascene. We called him in Syria, Abdul Dimashqi. Have you been in Rome? Have you been in Rome, anyone?
Yes.
Have you seen that huge column? It's called Trojan columns?
Yeah.
With a curving it?
Yeah.
That column design and constructed by Syrian architect, his name Apollodor Zadamasin. And Apollodor Zadamasin, he does design many Roman cities. So during Roman time, we were active. Anyway, late of 4th century, Roman state divided into two states, Byzantine and Roman. Late of 4th century, we became part of that Roman, Byzantine Christian state. Many churches built in that, beautiful church built in that time. But Christianity, by the way, started in Syria early of 1st century, when we went to the church of St. Hanania. We talk about St. Paul. He started his journey from Damascus, and then he went to Europe, and the name of the Lord was well known after his journey. And he started his journey from Damascus. Anyway, Arab and Muslim. Okay. Arab and Muslim arrived to Syria or captured Syria in the year 636 AD. Then Damascus became capital of the world. 7th and 8th century AD, Damascus, it was the capital of the world from China to Spain. During, it's called Umayyad time, when Umayyad mosque date back to from Spain to China. And then 750 AD, the capital moved to Baghdad, to Iraq. And that time, that period is called Abbasid period. Abbasid period officially lasted till 12th century. 12th, 13th, 14th century, it was very bad time for Syrian. A lot of blood, many troubles, because Mongols attacked Syria many times and crusaders. From the east, Mongols, from the west, crusaders. A lot of Arab blood, Mongol blood, European blood for nothing. All of them, they left Syria without any advantage.
Genghis Khan?
Genghis Khan, yes. Especially Mongols, they killed a lot of Syrian. Anyway, as I said, all of them, they left Syria. They left Syria without any advantage. War is not answer. 1516 AD, of course. Ottoman occupied Syria. From 1516 till 1918, this completely black period. No education, nothing. And they ask...
1918.
I repeat, 1516 till 1918. 400...
18.
Yeah, sorry. This 400 years. What Ottoman did? Ask women to cover the face. Made Islam complicated. By the way, covering the face is not Islamic rules. Because Prophet Muhammad wives, they showed their faces. But Ottoman, to control the people, they made Islam very complicated. And something very important. When Ottoman occupied Damascus, only Damascus, they were in Damascus 500 school. After 400 years of Ottoman occupation, there was only 10 school. And religious school. Education, it was the first enemy for Ottoman.
First victims.
And same now. Well,
same
if you ask,
thing now.
Same thing. No.
I would tape this, but my thing ran out.
I repeat that for you if you want any time.
No, that's okay. Yeah.
So, anyway, we had the independence from Ottoman authority 1918. Only 1.5 year. Then France occupied Syria. In 1920. France occupied Syria from 1920 to 1946. This also was troubles between Syrian resistance and the French arms. Anyway, they left Syria in 1946, like this day. Today, day of independence. From 1946 till 1970, this independent time. But no security, no stability. You know why? Each few months we have a new government. Many military movement. Till 1970, there's a correction or what is called correction or corrective movement under leadership of late President Hafez Assad. He ruled Syria about 30 years. Always, I have been working as a tour guide, I work with media, always they ask me question, if he is dictator or not dictator. To tell you what he did in 30 years. When he became in power, 1970s, he was in Syria, all Syria, 2,000 school, or less than 2,000 school. In the year of 2000, there was in Syria 22,000 school. So he constructed, during his time, we constructed more than 20,000 school. And before 2011, you cannot find anyone from 10 year old till 40 year old at least cannot read and write. Young generation, all young generation educated. This one thing. Second thing, he made Syria more than self-sufficient in food, dress, and medication. Something else. During Ottoman time, there was no Syrian state, French time occupation, at the beginning. He established a state.